So if you remember your number pairs that make 10, we were doing addition and we would do the two numbers that you put together to make 10. If you remember those numbers and you know you're making 10 numbers, this exercise in subtraction is going to be very easy for you. And let me show you exactly what I mean. All right. So you will need to be on page 422, 422 of your math book. Let's take a look at this very first example that has the soccer balls. Now they already have 10 written down for you. You need to trace the subtraction sign and you need to trace the number 8. Trace the number 8. Now, if you remember what number you put with 8 to make 10, you already know the answer to this subtraction problem. 10 minus 8. Well, there are 10 soccer balls altogether. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. They took away 8 of them. They X'd them out. How many are left over? 2 are left over. So if you remembered that if you add together 8 and 2, you get 10, it's going to make this a whole lot easier when you know those number pairs. This would be a fact family. 10, 8, and 2 would be a fact family. So let's do another example down here with these basketballs. There are 10 basketballs altogether. We know that. They already have it written down for us. We are going to take some of those basketballs away. We're going to subtract, so trace that minus sign because we are subtracting 3 basketballs from the 10. If you remember what number you put with 3 to make 10, you already know the answer to this problem without even counting. How many are left? All right, you know what the answer is. You know what it equals. So trace that equal sign, 10 minus 3. So we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. We have 7 as our answer because if you put together 7 and 3, you get 10. So 10 minus 3 equals 7. This is a fact family set. The numbers 3, 7, and 10 our fact family, just like what we've been working on the calendar. All right. So, how many of you said 7 before we even counted? Probably quite a few. All right. Now, there are 10 baseballs. I already know there are 10 baseballs because they have the number 10 written down right there to tell me that. We are subtracting some of those baseballs. So, we have to trace our subtraction sign. We're actually subtracting 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And some of you are probably already saying the answer. I know some of you are just so good at math, you already know what this equals. Trace that equal sign. 10 minus 5. So we had 10, we took away these 5, we still have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 left over. How do we know that without even counting? Well, if you know that 5 plus 5 equals 10, you know that 10 minus 5 has to equal 5. These are fact families, right? 5, 5, and 10 would make up a fact family. All right, let's do some more. Turn to page 423. 423, we're doing exactly the same thing, just a little more practice. And I'll go up here and grab my pen. We have 10 footballs. I know there are 10 footballs. They already wrote 10. We're going to be taking some of those footballs away. So trace that subtraction sign to show takeaway. Well, we actually took away 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. We actually took away 9 of those. Well, what does that equal? Trace that equal sign. It equals 1 left over. 1 left over. So if you knew that 1 and 9, when you put 1 and 9 together, it makes 10, it makes this whole subtraction thing a whole lot easier, right? If you know your addition facts, your subtraction facts will come a lot faster. 10 minus 9 equals 1. 10 minus 9 equals 1. So 1, 9, and 10 are a fact family. All right, so we got some hoops to subtract down here. So let's see. There are 10 hoops. I know they're 10. They told me so. But I'm going to take away some of them, so I have to trace that subtraction sign. I actually took away 2 of them. So I take away 2. How many does that equal? Trace your equal sign. And if you know the number that you put with 2 to make 10, you already know the answer. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I could just about hear some of you telling me that answer, right? You already knew that 10 minus 2 equals 8. We had 10 hoops. We took 2 away. Now we have 8. All right, let's do a little subtraction with the baseball bats here. That's a nice spring sport. We're in the spring. I know I have 10 bats. They told me so. And I also know I have to take some away. So I'm tracing that subtraction sign. How many did I take away? 1, 2, 3. I took away 3. Now to find out what that equals, I might know what number I put with 3 to make 10. And if I do, I already know the answer to this problem. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. There are 7 bats left. I had 10, I took away 3, and now I have 7. 10 minus 3 equals 7. Turning the page to page 424. Some of you may not know this sport, but this is lacrosse. And Alima Senior is lucky enough to have a lacrosse team, and not a lot of schools in our area do. But this is a lacrosse field. So we are doing, there are 10 lacrosse sticks. You see the 10 lacrosse sticks scattered on the field? All right. Only 6 players show up to play. So we take away 6 of them because 6 players are going to walk out and take their sticks. So we are going to be subtracting 6. All right. So minus 6. And how do we show takeaway? Well, we X them out. So we're taking away 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Now we want to know how many lacrosse sticks are left. Well, if you know what number you put with 6 to make 10, you already know the answer. You already know what that equals. Trace your equal sign. 1, 2, 3, 4. You have 4 lacrosse sticks left over. 10 minus 6 equals 4. When you put 6 and 4 together, they make 10. So this is a fact family. 4, 6, and 10 is part of a fact family. All right, you will be doing page 225 and 226 on your own. And you can see they look exactly like what you've been doing, but you're not subtracting sporting equipment, you are subtracting toys this time. So page 425, 426, when you're all done, upload that work to Schoology.